from that briefing today with the fact that the White House wouldn't even acknowledge that she made the remark, just simply apologize for it and move on from there. But the White House there saying they're not going to comment on internal leaks inside the meeting. Of course, Meghan McCain, during that thing, of course, I reported last night that Sadler did call McCain and apologize for the remark that she made. It's unclear what McCain's response was to Sadler, but there we heard from her on The View today saying, really raising the question that a lot of people here in Washington are also asking, Kate, which is why does Kelly Sadler still have this job here in the White House with no apology or anything else from the White House?
Yeah, the simple answer seems to be because the president's allowing her to keep having that job. Caitlin, thanks so much. Great to see you. Out front with me now, Reed Galen, former deputy campaign manager for Senator McCain's presidential campaign. Joan Walsh is here, national affairs correspondent at The Nation. And Rick Santorum, of course, a former senator from Pennsylvania. Thank you all so much for being here. Reed, first to you, where do you land on all of this? Is it fair to put this on the president when this comment came from a staffer?
You know, I think it is for a couple of reasons. One, you know, I've been privileged enough to work at the White House for President George W. Bush, and I can tell you that, you know, he set the tone, and it was one of respect and one of dignity, not only for the people that work there, but for all Americans. And I think I can tell you this, that if this had happened while President Bush was in office, first you would have been marched to the Oval Office to explain yourself, and you would have been frog marched to the Northwest Gate. And so when you work at the White House, you represent and you reflect the president. And I think, unfortunately, this is just one more reflection of President Trump.
Senator, where do you land on this? I mean, well, first let me play probably the most important voice in all this is John McCain's family. Here is what Caitlin alluded to it, but here is what Meghan McCain said today. Listen.
I don't understand what kind of environment you're working in when that would be acceptable, and then you can come to work the next day and still have a job.
Do you think the staffer should be fired, Senator?
If she said it, then there should have been some discipline. As to whether she's fired or not, I don't know. There should have been some disciplinary action, and they should have owned up to it. And, you know, there's plenty of blame to go around here. The person who leaked is reprehensible in my mind. Reprehensible because you leak something that obviously is going to hurt, hurt the president. It obviously is a rude and foul thing to say that we don't need in our public discourse. So who is this leaker that supposedly works in the White House? That to me is equally atrocious. And then I agree with the other commentators that, you know, the president holds some responsibility here for setting that tone. And presidents do set tones. There's no doubt about that.
But Senator, is it equal, though, the fact that the comment was said or the fact that someone leaked it out? You think those things are equally egregious?
Yeah, I do, because, you know, comments are said all the time, as we all know. I mean, everyone's going to sit here and say, oh, no one ever says anything foul or crude at internal meetings. It happens all the time. Unfortunately, it happens all the time. And it shouldn't, but it does. And the reality is that the person who leaked it took something that was a private thing that would never have gotten out and put it out there in the public stage. And so, yes, I think they are very, very culpable in this situation. They've added, you know, they've added fuel to the fire.
Joan, what about you?
Well, I think we've learned two things about this White House, or maybe we've had two things confirmed, Kate. One is the president is a nasty man. He sets the tone at the top. He has mocked a disabled.
You think this confirms he's a nasty man?
Yes, I do think it's on him. I absolutely think that he has set a tone where somebody would be sitting in a meeting in the White House and think, ha, this is funny. We can mock John McCain. Our boss has mocked John McCain repeatedly. No problem. So there's that. The other side of it, and I'm not going to agree with Senator Santorum, but I will point out, this White House is a snake pit. People are leaking constantly. We are having conversations about leaked comments, leaked insults, backbiting constantly. So it was a little bit rich for Sarah Sanders to say, I won't dignify a leak. I'm not going to talk about a leak, because she talks about leaks. You know, half of her business is responding to the latest, what has the president said about John Kelly? Is Rex Tillerson out the door? No. Yes, of course he was. So she's constantly having to. She deigns to, or she doesn't deign to. She deigned not to today, because this is embarrassing.
Well, Reed, on the specific question of just civility and politics, call me Pollyanna, you sure can. Do you think that we have hit rock bottom here?
You know, I don't know if we've hit rock bottom, but certainly, you know, as an old friend of mine used to say, you know, when you worked in Washington or you work in politics, you wore your red jersey, you wore your red, you know, your blue jersey, and at the end of the day, you took those things off and you were opponents, you weren't enemies. Mm-hmm. And I think we've traded those jerseys in American politics for war paint. We now see each other as enemies, not as opponents, not as people who want to do right by the American people or best for the American people, but how do we win the zero-sum game that I think Washington really has become today?
Senator, let's nail down on this issue of the leaks, because I know this is something that you think is egregious. You don't have to look very far. It was not long ago that President Trump loved leaks. If we need a refresher, here it is.
This just came out. WikiLeaks. I love WikiLeaks.
Another one came in today. This WikiLeaks is like a treasure trove.
I will tell you this. Russia, if you're listening, I hope you're able to find the 30,000 emails that are missing.
So is it a little rich for the White House now to say that they aren't going to be responding to any leaks?
Yeah, the president, I mean, candidate Trump was referring to potential legal activity that was going on. And you know, that's a different thing. If it's a leak of that nature, you're talking about whistleblowing as much as you're talking about leaking. I mean,
you're talking about stolen. Those are stolen emails. Those are emails that were actually stolen.
This was egregious in the sense that there was who benefits from this? I mean, it's a horrible, tawdry thing to say. Besmirches the name of John, or attempts to besmirch the name of John McCain.
Right, it does.
It's just, and it hurts the president, hurts the whole discussion. That's the kind of stuff there's just no place for.
No, but I mean, but kind of to the senator's point, if these leaks happen so much, and I mean, this is one example today, there's another example about coming out of the cabinet meeting with Kirstjen Nielsen.
Right.
When it comes to this, does the president, Joan, then have strong footing when he thinks everyone's out to get him?
Well, people in his own White House seem to be out to get him sometimes. I mean, seriously, there is dysfunction from the top. It goes straight down the organization. He's beset with leaks, but I think he's created the situation where people are backbiting, people have rivalries. I mean, that's true in every workplace,
yeah.
Kate, but this is worse than I think we've ever seen. I just want to warn you about something. You asked about whether we've hit bottom. Never say bottom with this president. I promise you.
I wouldn't even put it on this president. I just think the state of Washington right now, it's bottom until, well, let's see, tomorrow. Great to see you guys. I really appreciate it. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
Up front next, General John.